Hello everyone, welcome to today's editorial analysis. So editorial analysis is from the Hindu as well as from the Indian Express. This is the initiative of Apti Plus, and the entire initiative is powered by ISGyan. Before starting the editorial session, I would like to inform about the initiative of Apti Plus for the answer writing challenge. So what you can do, there will be every day, there will be three questions in the morning. You can post your comment, you can post your answer, and by 6 a.m. you will be getting the model answer by our expert. So this would be, you know, a value addition to your answer writing skills, and completely you can enrich your comprehensive the way of writing the answer you're writing. Indeed would be helpful for the examination. Now the other you can also enroll for the mock test series for CSE 2019. There will be 14 tests, 8 sectional, 4 full length and 2 essay writing tests. You can enroll this both online as well as offline. For more details, you can refer to the contact number mentioned below, or you can refer to our website also. Now, starting with the today's editorial analysis, the first and the foremost editorial in the Hindu talks about the padding up for the next UNSC inning. So this is an important editorial. This could be important for your general studies paper 2. Okay, general studies paper 2. And expected that a question on UNSC reform could be asked this year as well. But this is an evergreen topic with any time can come. So make sure that you have ample content so that anytime the question is coming, any year, whichever year you are appearing, you can easily handle that question. So in this editorial, the editor talks about that India has served as the longest non-member in the UNSC. So among the Asia Pacific group, is the India is the longest serving non-permanent member now. And the good news which has come, like the unanimously the countries has decided that India will continue for the 8th term. This would be important for you. India would be continuing the 8th term for the non-permanent members. Okay, the election was run from calendar 2021 to 2022. So this is on the background of that. This could be important which term India is serving, and is also talk about the role of India, the pivotal role of India which has been occupied in the UNSC. So it talks about in future coming how India could also go for the permanent seat, but it's a way far now. But it has given the clarity that India, despite the other Asia Pacific region, has done reasonably well in the UNSC. So definitely you can extract some of the important point. I'm not getting into the detail of this editorial because we had already made editorial videos on UNSC. So I request you to please refer that video so to make more clarity on this topic. Now the second editorial which is there in the Hindu, it talks about the making of the digital kleptocracy. Okay, kleptocracy. So this is basically this talks about what is the government, how the digital data is being shared, okay, with the other agencies. So it talks about the privacy of data. So we'll be having an in-depth analysis in this. Okay, we'll be having an in-depth analysis, and this could be important for your general studies paper 3 as well. I'll tell you where it could be important when we'll have the complete analysis of this. Now moving to the editorial from the Hindu, the second page, it is like focusing on the critical year of the child development. See, in this editorial talks about the recent national education policy has omitted the chapter of early child care and education, being this very important. No, I mean, you cannot definitely ignore that. And the data found by the Lancet has also quoted that almost the optimum brain level is at age of 6. Okay. And the development of the first 100 days is for personal life also. See, so this would be important because, again, main ye batana chahunga ki jo national education policy ke editorial is again repeated in the news. If you're following us editorial analysis, yet this is for the 5th or 6th time this has come. So every time it is coming with the different aspects. Har samay ek naye pehlu pe baat ki ja rahi hai. Theek hai, kabhi languages pe baat ki gayi, कभी उसके पॉलिसीज पे बात की, कभी फंडिंग्स पे बात की. ठीक है, तो दिस इज ऑन द चैप्टर ऑफ अर्ली, दिस टॉक्स अबाउट द अर्ली केयर एंड चाइल्डहुड. तो डेफिनेटली आपने जो भी नोट्स बनाया है, जस्ट ट्राई टू ऐड ऑन दैट पॉइंट्स, बिकॉज दिस वुड बी अगेन इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर जनरल स्टडीज पेपर 3. ओके, प्रिसाइजली, एंड ऑल्सो फॉर द हेल्थ सेक्शन. ओके, व्हेन इट टॉक्स अबाउट द अर्ली चाइल्ड केयर्स, व्हेन इट टॉक्स अबाउट द, इट कैन बी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर पेपर 1 एज अ सोसाइटी एज वेल. ओके, So make sure that you have filtered out some of the important point needed for the examination. Now the other editorial there is Hindu is like the leaf of the Yunnan book. Okay, so this is on the Yunnan book. So this is would be not that relevant for your examination because it's mostly talk about the border trade and the ecotourism. So you can extract some of the important point relevant for you, because here and there whatever is reported in the Hindu can be important for the examination. So we cannot ignore the fact that, you know, the pointers which can be important can be written down. Now the last one in the corner end is talks about the Odisha model. So basically talks about the empowerment of the Biju Janata Dal government there. So what they have done, they have empowered women in the panchayat. Okay, and Odisha would be the country, Odisha would be the first state in the country which have reserved 50% of the seat in the PRI. Okay, how much? 50% of the seat, public institution. Okay, and talking about the recent 2016 Lok Sabha election, so what it did, like apart from the number of candidate who has secured has increased substantially from 11%. The previously in the 14 election it was around 11%, right? So it has increased to 14%. It has increased to 14%. So definitely you can remember this. This could be important, and definitely this would be important. This editorial, there's a piece of information, I can say the article would be important for your general studies paper one as well, when it talks about the society issues, the women empowerment. This can be important there, and it could be important as a part of general studies paper two, where it talks about the governance. Okay, or the paper two where it talks about the PRIs. So it can be important there as well. So definitely this would be important. Just read it out. I mean, apart from leaving this, you can definitely focus on this one. Fine, leave this Yuan book. It's not that important. Now moving, before getting into the in-depth of this editorial, we'll be getting the idea of what is there in the Indian Express. So the first Indian Express talks about the case of migration of the MLAs. See, this is on the background of Goa and Karnataka issues, the anti-defection law, the role of the speaker. Again, a repetition of news. So I would not focusing and not take much of your time. Now, the second editorial talks about the ban on the cryptocurrency. The government committee has recommended that the cryptocurrency is unrealistic. So this again can be important when it's come to the economic section. Precisely, if I talk about paper 3, it can also come on the part of the science and technology. Okay. So this can be important for your pre-examination also. So try to filter out and just understand the concept of cryptocurrency as well, because this time UPSC might ask prelims questions. So try to understand this also. This would be important for you. Now the other editorial in the Indian Express talks about the blueprint of the city. So this talks about how the urban planning, what would be the roadmap of the metropolitan cities. Okay, so this would be again important, and it has given a picture that the urban that the problem of urbanization can be how taken care of, because this is also there in the general studies paper 3. A special topic dedicated to urbanization is there. So please read this and extract, filter some of the important point relevant for the examination. Now the other article which would be there and talks about is Mr. Kiran Rejiju. So it talks about the 15-day journey. So this is basically the praise for the government. This would be the pro-government article. I mean, if you want, just read out some, because har samay aap answer mein critic nahi de sakte, means ki answer mein kuch agar positive yahan pe hai, to filter it out. But वैसे it's not that relevant for your examination. Now the other article which is also there in the Hindu talks about the big data, big responsibility. So what we'll be doing, we'll be clubbing this editorial to this editorial of the Hindu. Okay, we'll be clubbing this. So do not worry, I'll club the important point from both of the article or editorial reported. So now moving back to our editorial analysis, the making of the digital kleptocracy. So this talks about, this is basically on the background of the economic survey reported ki how the data are becoming toxic and harmful for the public interest. This is by Ritika Khera. She is an associate professor of Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad. So she talks about, we'll be getting into the details as well, and some of the other important knowledge base which is also relevant for you. I'll be including that as well. So let's get started. So it talks about key, what should be the rule. I mean, the digital data, the data which has been stored by the government, how this can be, you know, it very limited. It talks about first digital kleptocracy. So it talks about okay, the recent economic survey has told that the monetized of the data can become toxic and harmful for the public interest. So this was being forecasted in economic survey. So what exactly is the kleptocracy? So this is basically when a government with the intention of corrupt, this is the basically a core definition which I'm mentioning. You can customize it according to your requirement. Okay, when the corrupt government ruler uses the power to exploit the people or resources in their own territory to extend the personal wealth and political power. So India, it could be for the political power as well, because because I'll tell you how the personal wealth has also been accumulated, and that the Indra Sabha Ministry of Road and Transport Minister has also told that India has an, I mean, 65 crore, the ministry has an 65 crore from the data shared by the insurance company. Okay, so I'll get into the details of that, but I just want to clarify what exactly is the definition so that you can figure it out, you do not get confused. Okay, now. So in this editorial, the editor has given her view, given her personal experiences. So this I have included because to understand, aapko ye pata chal jaye ki kaise, matlab kya difference ki baat ki ja rahi hai, theek hai? So what she did, she has filed an RTI, okay? And the RTI RTI 2005, and she denied, and the access was denied to her. ठीक है, उसको उन्होंने जो एक पूछा था आरटीआई में कि जो एजेंसीज है यूएआईडी, जो यूआईडी के जो इमेज मेक ओवर हुई है उसके पीछे कितना खर्चा है, व्हाट वाज द एक्सपेंसेस दैट वाज इनकर्ड. सो सी आस्क्ड फॉर दिस इंफॉर्मेशन एंड द इंफॉर्मेशन वाज डिनाइड अंडर द आरटीआई एक्ट 2005, एंड द एग्जेम्पशन क्लॉजेस व्हिच वाज मेंशन वाज 8D. सो द कमर्शियल, इट टॉक्स, दे हैव गिवन, दे हैव साइटेड द रीजन दैट द कमर्शियल कॉन्फिडेंस, the commercial confidence and the trade secrets of the intellectual property right and the unwanted invasion of the privacy of the individual. So is ground pe they have not given the information. So she wanted to tell you ki itne chote se information ko unko nahi bataya gaya, but at the same time jo apne paas jo hamare jo important jo insurance ki data hai jo aur jo important data hai wo ministries ne sell kiya hai, they have purchased it. To kya matlab important information is not being shared with the people, at the same time it is being sold, it is being monetized, the data has been getting monetized. So wahan pe us concern mein puri editorial ko describe kiya gaya. And she also talks ki the recent the RTI amendment 2019 jo aaya hai usme there are many others, you know, things which has been undermined. To is pe bhi humne ek video banaya hua, we have made a separate video on the RTI amendment 2019. So those who want, you can refer this. I'll not get into the details of that because that is a very crisp video. Please refer that. Now it talks there is a question of data opaqueness. Okay, so what has happened, like there has been a delay in the release of data. I mean, talking about the government, the data which is being collected by the government. So the government is not coming with the data as a, see, data are very important. I'll tell you what are the things where we use the data. So the data on such the important data like the farmer suicide data is not made public. The data on the employment or unemployment also not made public. Okay, the migrations, talking about the employment and the unemployment. And the migration of migration data on the census is also not made public. And the recent NCRB data was again the controversial, but the government has admitted that they'll be discussing the data. So this was also skipped. Now the controversy over the methodology used to calculate the GDP growth rate is also in the question. So there is a data opaqueness. यहाँ पे कहीं ना कहीं एक no clarity नहीं है. There is no clarity about how the data is being collected. Being a citizen of this country, being an enlightened citizen of this country, we should aware that हमें क्या हम किस किस तरह से data हो रहे, we want, हमें जानने का वो ज़रूरत है. Now the data are the backbone of the policy making. क्यों ज़रूरत है? Because data would be the backbone of the policy making. Talking about the information that are obtained through the RTI Act would be a pivotal. Tough important होता है. I mean you can get some of the trivial information from there, but again there are some limitation also for that. This can, the administrator data can also be used for as the policy making, and the data is collected by the statistical machineries. Okay, यहाँ पे जो statistical machineries है of the government, वहाँ पे भी data can be used for the public good. Okay, that the sole purpose of the data collection is to make a policy for the public good. Okay, So this is the main reason that, we want that data should be made to the public, because until and unless you are not aware of the fact what exactly is needed, what policy need to be formulated, the data could be the only supportive way. Okay. So some of the recent incident of the data privacy has also been discussed, like a former Chief Justice of India has dubbed with the 1 lakh rupees of the fraudulent email, and in same time the Mumbai the personal data was being taken by the fraudulent with the number of Aadhaar number and the mobile numbers. The phishing case has also been reported by the fraudulent banking customers. I mean, you have also come across some of the people asking for your debit card details and other CVV numbers. So do not report to that card. That are very dangerous. They can land up to any of the bigger problem. Now the survey has also postulated that the reason for the personal data, the survey treated the personal data such as mobile, date of number and addresses has been misused over the time. Okay. So this is again a cause of concern. We'll be dealing separately in the concern section. Now, what is the concern? I mean, talking about the economic survey has also raised an alarm that talks about that in 2019, there's an alarming situation that India is facing. And the survey also proposed that the data is being sold for the prices. Okay, the data. So this is the main theme of this analysis what we're doing. So data should not be sold for the prices, and it was being validated by the government, and that the Union Minister of Transport Mr. Nitin Gadkari has said, they informed the parliament that the department has earned 65 crore rupees with the sale of the vehicle registration and the license data. See, this is again a problematic. I mean, when you are sharing this data, it can be there with the insurance company, that can be there with the any other entity who are involved there. So it can again share you any of the trivial information, be it Aadhaar card. Okay, Aadhaar is there, your date of birth, your mobile number. Okay, this can be used by multiple agency. The problem is not only with the vehicle registration and the insurance. It can be used for the multiple. Just say agar the example is there, some of the the messages which used to be come there, that like the you can enroll yourself, just go to, you have this much credit limit, you can avail 2 lakh rupees of the loan. So is like information mein wo aapke kafi important data le lete hain, be it PAN card or other things. So don't avoid using that messages, just reply to that messages that can be harmful for you. As far as the PAN card and other the trivial data of your concern, so please avoid using that. Now the expanding of the data footprint of the people is again important. I mean, it has getting the digital footprint is in a expanding mode. Now the falling of the cost of the data, I mean, if you have read in the economic survey, it is there on the chapter that how the falling cost of the data generation is there is again would be the cause of concern. Now the data, now the storage and the growing of the data in the and the growing basically the data mining industry, the privacy, the privacy policies which is there, I mean the duplication of the data and how it has been mined. Mining here means it has been channelized to the other entity as well. Okay. So the growing of data mining industry is again a big cause of concerns. And when talks about treating to the personal data, you the individual need to take care of ki aap kisi bhi aise phishing informations pe ya kisi bhi is tarah ki jo messages hain ya jo emails hain, you do not reply to that. So and again the awareness is also needed. We'll be discussing that on the way forward. So what would be the way forward, how we could come across this, the problem which is existent, the data stolen, the data privacy is there. See, definitely a stringent data protection and the privacy law need to be enacted immediately by the government, because see, I mean, we do not need to experiment with the public, the expenditure, whatever is there, the trivial data are there, we cannot experiment. So a stringent data and protection law is the need of the hour. Now talking about the other initiative which from we can do, that the public awareness on the data protection is also very important. Do not share any of the important data, the Aadhaar card, the mobile number, the PAN card number, be it anything, DL, other things, do not share it. So the public awareness is also very important. Now there need to be a law and authority that could regulate so that data could not be used for the profit, basically for the monetization purpose or for any purposes. Okay, so this cannot be used there. Now further, the privacy of the data laws and the unique implementation and its challenges, it would be also a good pretty challenge to implement it. So how we implement, the way, the sustainable way, the holistic manner need to be needed, And at the same time, we need to consider all the stakeholders with this. We need to have a discussion paper also. So definitely, a data protection law need to be enacted. So this was on the background of the digital data, the stolen, and the interest, how the public interest is being harmed with the data that has been shared with the other agencies also. So this could be important for your general studies paper 2 and paper 3, fine, where it talks about there is a law and regulation, and there has been a lot of talk about the digital privacy, the data privacy. Okay, so you can expect that here and there could be a collaboration of questions. It can club with the privacy and the data as such. So wo dono mein it can be asked. So this was there from the editorial. If you have any other concern, just let us know. We'll be more than happy to answer your queries. For time being, I'm signing off, and thank you for listening. Keep your work hard, keep rocking.